Rajesh Kumar is a senior public servant with a reputation of honesty and forthrightness, currently posted in the Finance Ministry as the head of the Budget Division. His department is presently busy in organizing the budgetary support to the states, four of which are due to the go polls within the financial year. This year's annual budget had allotted Rs 8,300 crores for National Housing Scheme, a centrally sponsored social housing scheme for the weaker sections of the society. Rs 775 crores have been drawn from the NHS till June. Ministry of Commerce had long been pursuing a case for setting up a special economic zone in the southern state to boost exports. After 2 years of detailed discussions between the center and the state, the Union Cabinet approved the project in August. Process was initiated to acquire the necessary land. 18 months ago, a leading public sector unit had projected the need for setting up a large natural gas processing plant in a northern state for the regional gas grid. The required land is already in possession of the PSU. The gas grid is an essential component of the national energy security strategy. After 3 rounds of the global bidding, the project was allotted to an MNC. XYZ Hydrocarbons. The first tranche of payment to the MNC is scheduled to be made in December. Finance Ministry was asked for a timely allocation of additional Rs 6,000 crores for these two development projects. It was decided to recommend re-appropriation of this entire amount from NHS allocation. The file was forwarded to Budget Department for their comments and further processing. On studying the case file, Rajesh Kumar realized that this reappropriation may cause inordinate delay in the execution of NHS, and not a project much publicized in the rallies of senior politicians. Correspondingly, non-availability of finances would cause financial loss in the SEZ and national embarrassment due to delayed payment in an international project. Rajesh Kumar discussed the matter with his seniors. He was conveyed that this political sensitive situation needs to be processed immediately. Rajesh Kumar realized the diversion of the funds from NHS could raise difficult questions for the government in the parliament. This was the description of the event, sir. Discuss following with reference to this case. First question is, the ethical issues involved in reappropriation of the funds from a welfare project to the development project.
Absolutely. It's the prerogative of the government to allocate funds and budget to any project based on robust public interest and common good and welfare of the people. That should be the criterion on which budget can be allotted, reallocated, and therefore it's the prerogative of the government. I see that a commitment, if has been made, has to be honored. A commitment, as you said, that had been made by senior politicians during the course of public rallies. A commitment once made has to be honored, especially those pertaining to welfare issues. But development itself is welfare. Development regenerates the economy. And many welfare projects can be dovetailed with development and industrialization that generates employment and boosts the economy and is generally a win-win situation for all. I see no contradiction, but yes, a priority has to be made on the basis of what is in immediate public interest with no eye on the impending elections in the four states. That should not be a consideration.
So the next question is, given the need for proper utilization of the public funds, discuss the options available to the Rajesh Kumar. Is resigning a worthy option?
Resignation is just not an option. These issues come by the dozen every day. One has to stand up and face the absolute challenges that administration brings every now and then. And this is a routine exercise of reallocation of funds. Resignation is just not an option. He should ensure and give an unambiguous, clear and a logical report, basing his arguments on larger public interest. Also, weighing how it will impact the credibility of the government in view of the public commitment made by senior politicians during the course of public rallies. Therefore, I see that Mr. Rajesh's job is very simple. Intellectual integrity and probity, transparency, putting up his arguments very logically, cogently in public interest, with malice towards none, yet firmness in the right. And therefore, I feel that this is the right course of action. Resignation is just not the solution.
To have more such discussions and analysis, subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon for notifications on our upcoming videos.